Hello dear photographers and welcome to my channel. In this photography channel, today in this video, I'm going to talk to you about the Silver EFEX Pro 3. Silver EFEX Pro 3, it's a part of Nick collection by DXO. And personally, I love black and white photography and I like to edit a lot of black and white photography because I believe this is a true form of art. Less distraction, less color, it can focus on the story. Anyway, in this particular video, I'm actually going to show you how to use this software. And we're going to go through step by step from the beginning to the end. So let's jump into the tutorial right now. So this is how the interface looks like. Before I explain you how the software works, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to one of my picture folder and drag and drop a photo. So either I can find something like minimalist like this one, maybe a cat, or maybe a female artist like one of those. So what I'm going to do, I am going to select this one because I think this will give a really nice look. So as I drag and dropped, it gave me a box saying things to know before working with a TIFF file. Since you imported images in TIFF format, you have the ability to resume editing later. Enable this option by clicking the checkbox next to the image information. This is brilliant. So that means that I can resume it whenever I want if I leave behind and let's say I have to take a break, etc. Now, the photo already looks just beautiful. Now, this is the box that you should click in order to come back later. Now, on the left-hand side, you have all the presets. So that's the easy one. So you have all together 58 presets here. Now we're going to show you 5 or 6 of them. Now, they are again categorized in 5 sections. Classic, modern, 25th anniversary. I think that's their special. En vogue, that's in French, and vintage. So let's show you some example quickly before I jump into the sliders on the right hand side. Now I already love this look, which is actually part of the neutral. Now I'm going to go to the classic department and let's see what they have to provide. So this is, I think, the underexposed. This is overexposed, which is another of my favorite. And this is the high contrast, not the most beautiful look for portrait, but I believe for landscape or minimalist photography, this is just phenomenal. This is a high key. Again, just wow. That's it. I cannot have any other word than that. You see, this is why I love photography, especially the black and white. I can go on and on and on. So let's jump to the modern department. Let's show you some examples. So you can already see the result here, which is a very good thing. So I'm going to click the full speed, I believe. And maybe this one looks good. It's contrasty, but man, it has something hard to explain. This is probably one of my favorite. I'm just going to save it as a favorite. Now, moving on to anniversary. In the anniversary, I love this look. It has like a really nice bluish sepia tone. And this is the classic portrait. Again, super old school. I like it. I think this is the similar one as a gritty look as the modern, where I think it was there. There you go. Not much different, almost similar. Street high contrast, not bad either. The thing about the contrasty look is that the black is pure black and white is pure white, and the eyes look just beautiful. Let me show you the eyes. In any portrait photography, the eyes are your friend. You have to make sure that they look the most beautiful, well focused. Now, en vogue, I never heard of it, but let's see some of the example. Okay, so this is like a soft look, I guess. There you go. Now this one, one-on-one. How the eyes look like? Look so dreamy. This one looks pretty much the soft look as before, just a minor adjustment, nothing much different. I think as you can clearly tell that I'm a big fan of either high key soft look or contrasty look. Let's see the vintage. I believe the vintage, or as you can imagine, it gives you the old black and white look. Generally works perfectly for the portrait photography. This is my favorite, I think. That's it. I found one of my favorite. Anyway, moving on. Now I'm going to go back to the neutral and start from the scratch. I recommend you to select one of the preset first. So you have to understand that what you are looking for. You are looking for neutral. Are you looking for high key, low key, contrast key, and so on. So this is a good thing about the preset. You can select one of them. So this is where the... That's why I don't want to show you my tutorial and my method. I want to show you how the tool works, because you can clearly see that there are thousands of examples. Each of them has their own taste. So I don't want to push my idea into yours. I just want to show you the tools here. So I'm going to, in my case, select the most plain look possible. So this is a little too bright. I want to start from the neutral, this one. So that looks perfect. Now, I'm going to go all the way to the top and explain you exactly how the interface works. So at the bottom, you have the custom. This is where you will save your own personal look. Import it, you know, if you are sharing preset with somebody or giving it to somebody, you can bring it in and then use that right off the bat. And of course, you have a history look. So it shows every single thing that I have used at the very beginning, and you can go back and forth clicking them so that you know exactly where you are. So I'm going to go all the way back at the very beginning, the neutral, which is already was selected. And then I'm going to close it so that you have extra room to work for. Now at the top, you have the compare side by side. So nothing done yet, so you cannot really see it side by side. And you have the top and bottom. So this is a good thing. Now I can show you my edit while I'm leaving the original one in one side. This is beautiful. I love it. Now you have the full 1:1 and 2:1 zoom. So I'm going to go to the fit. And now I'm going to show you exactly all the tools on our right hand side. So starting with the loop. So this is where you can point it on the eye so that you can see exactly where the change is going on. I'm going to drop it on the eye. And to give you an understanding, this is where our edit going to happen, on the right hand side. So left photo will remain the same. So you understand what the loop is. But I need my histogram. So in order to understand the histogram, this is just a luminance look. So you have the L on, but you have the blue, green, and red, and RGB. And here you have seen all these things. What is this? So each time you put a cursor on top, it will show where it belongs. So for example, the pure white is not in the photo. It doesn't have any pure white. But if you go to the number 8, the shirt is the pure number 8 white. Then it moves on to the darkest part. So you can pinpoint exactly where you are editing. Now, second one is the global adjustment. So I would like to add a little bit of brightness. I don't need to work on the highlight because nothing is clipping, which is brilliant. Mid-tone looks good too, nice and bright. The shadow, maybe I will add some shadow instead of reducing it. Again, looks good. Dynamic brightness. This is the gritty look. I think this is where it gives you that dark eye and dark look. I'm going to zoom in 1:1 and show you the eyes. Wonderful, isn't it? I love it. Now I have found my look. Now, we're going to add some more contrast. So you have the traditional contrast, but I'm not going to use that. Amplify whites. I don't believe we need to amplify any whites because it's already been amplified. But I'm going to amplify a little bit more black here. Now it started to look even better. Nice, pure, contrasty. Now, in portrait, I tend to avoid structure, so I'm gonna reduce some structure. So what is structure? Why not just show you the example? I'm gonna do a fit. What I'm going to do, I'm gonna go all the way up to the 100 and you know exactly what structure does. It adds a local contrast. You don't really want that. It depends again. If you want a gritty look, I already found my gritty look with dynamic brightness. So I don't want to go more than that. Instead, if I reduce it, it adds a little bit nice softness. And I love it. I just love it. Then highlights, don't need to do it. Maybe I will reduce or add some black. That looks good. Finest structure. Again, what is this? So I'm going to go all the way up again. So it is similar to the structure, but more subtle. So I'm going to add a little bit more. And then we're not done here. So in the tonality protection, the shadow and highlight, basically, it tries to help protect your shadow so that it doesn't clip. So I'm going to go all the way up to 92. And the highlight is the same. It helps protect your highlight, especially on the white shirt. Very important. Now, fun of the day, the control points. So this is where you do the local adjustment. So I'm going to do some work on the face and make it a little bit bigger. And then by clicking show and hide selection of all control points, you can click it here. And you can see exactly where it's going to apply your edit. Very, very, very important tool. Amazing. I love it. And if you click this one, you can click the duplicate or you can delete one of them. And delete now. So once I'm done, I can start working on her face. But you can add brightness, for example, like that. But I don't want brightness here. What I want, amplify white. So I'm going to go back, go to the amplify, and add some brightness on her skin tone. And then amplify black. Maybe what I can do, I can add another control point on her eye, make it smaller like that, and amplify white there. And then same thing again, add the control point on her right eye, make it smaller, make sure that it's somewhere there, and make it even more small, and then amplify white as well. Now we are done in this department. I can do even more. Maybe I can add another control point on her cheek and maybe add a little bit white in that department too. Boom, that looks beautiful. You understand exactly how this works, and in the clear view, you can, you know, pull it all the way up, and again, it will look a little bit gritty. I like it again. So you have many ways to add this gritty look, which is wonderful. In the color filter, this is interesting. So imagine back in the day in the black and white photo, you used to add some color filter on your lens. This is similar. So if I click red, it will pump up the white, this orange, and you have the yellow, green, and the blue. In the portrait, generally, yellow is the best one, as the professional said back in the day. So I'm going to keep it to that. And film type. Now, fun part. So you have many stock. You have the Kodak, Ilford, Avga. Forma pen, you know, you name it, you have everything. So I'm going to find something nice looking. The Kodak T-Max looks good, punchy. They all look beautiful and fantastic. I don't know which one to pick. So I don't know about you. Maybe I'm going to pick something like Kodak P3200 T-Max Pro. That looks pretty awesome. But it's not done here. Then you can add grain, reduce grain if you like. Now, sensitivity, what is this? So let me show you the example. Like for example, if you click the red all the way down, it will reduce all the color from the red channel. Because remember, the skin is in the red zone. So because my subject's skin getting a little bit, you know, too bright, so I'm going to reduce some brightness from the skin. Yellow, it's in the red zone, but then again, somewhere spreading out, which is amazing. So I'm going to make it high key. Green, not much because it doesn't have much green in the image. Cyan, again, doesn't have anything to do because it doesn't have any sky there. Violet, again, I don't think it's going to do anything. Blue, I'm having a feeling that it might do something on her eyes. Maybe not. Right. So you get the idea. So it reduce or add brightness of each color channel. Now, moving on to my personal favorite, the curve. So you can, you know, pull all the way down or pull it up. You know what the curve does? It's the classic tool of any photography software. Personally, I love it. Now, film grain. Do you want to add more film grain or you want to reduce some more film grain? It's similar to one that at the before, but more film look. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add some kind of grain there. So you have a bunch of list. I'm going to add some Kodak HE. Looks good to me. And grain size, I'm going to make the grain even bigger. Wonderful. The photo has started to look so much better. It's unbelievable. Now, finishing adjustment. What is this? So, you know, you can completely avoid it or you can even work more in it, which means that you still want to do some final adjustment. What you can do, you can do silver hue and add some, you know, look into it. So I'm going to add some orange sepia look. And then silver toning. So it can go all the way up, or it can go all the way down. So it will, you know, add some extent on the silver hue look. So if you go to the green and add toning, it'll add some more green, or maybe no. So you get the idea what it does. And the balance, it can go back and forth. It reminds me of the same tool in Nikon Studio NX. You have the exact same tool there. Paper toning. What if I go to the cyan and add some paper toning? Holy crap, this looks so much better. It's unbelievable. Now, vignette. Would you like to add some vignette or you don't? I'm going to add some. That looks good. Burn edges. So you have plenty of choices. I'm going to add all edges soft. Then image border, again, you know the deal. You can add borders if you like. Personally, I'm not a big fan of the borders. Anyway, have I explained everything? I think I have, right? So yeah, you basically have an idea now how to use Silver FX Pro. It is a wonderful software if you are a big fan of black and white photography. Personally, I'm a big fan. So I'm going to use it in the coming months and I'm going to show you some more tutorial on landscape, minimalist photo, and etc. So stay tuned. I hope you like this tutorial. If so, please like and subscribe. And I see you in future videos. Bye bye.